I said I'm cool on it, baby, yeah. I'm straight. You say it's love, I don't want it, yeah.
Too late.
Buy you too much, too little, yeah.
Too late.
You do too much, too little, yeah.
Too late. Buy you too much, too little, yeah.
What's going on, y'all? It's me, your girl, Destiny Alima. I'm back again for another video. And I got my friend, Sanaya.
Hey, yo.
So today we're going to be answering questions about DSU, Delaware State University.
Morning.
So, the first question somebody said is, how long did it take to hear if you got accepted?
I'm gonna be honest with y'all, I didn't get anything like that because I applied to this school, but I didn't get like an email or a call saying like you got accepted. I just got a call saying we want to offer your daughter a Fulbright scholarship. So it wasn't really a email or a call saying like you're accepted into the school. It was like an automatic call saying that we want to offer her a Fulbright scholarship. I don't know how long the wait is, so I just know if you get offered a scholarship, most likely you probably will get a call or an email before acceptance letters go out. But that was just for me and my experience. But as far as other students, I really don't know because it just depends on what time you apply to come. You apply to college in general.
So for me, it took me like about like 2 or 3 months. Yeah, like they send you an email first, and then like a couple weeks later you get like the actual package in the mail, like with the folder.
Oh, I know all that.
So then they said, do they give you a heads up on when to apply for housing?
Yes and no.
Yeah, yes and no. It's like, yeah.
I think it depends on when you, get your acceptance letter, because once you get your acceptance letter, then you get a new student orientation.
They tell you all the information, when to apply for housing, when it opens. But when it opens, you need to be on it, like, ASAP. Like, once you get a date, like, yeah, let me get the money, let me figure out where I want to live ASAP, because it's first come, first serve.
For all of them. Yeah, even the best dorms here at Tubman, especially Tubman, if you really want to live in Tubman Laws, you have to hop on Tubman really quick, because these are more so for the upperclassmen.
Yes, when they're for freshmen. Freshmen's been asking, can they live in Tubman? You can live in Tubman, but you have to do it quick.
Quick. So, especially for you freshmen, if you want to live in Tubman and you get your, it's time for you to put your deposit in after you've been accepted, hop on it now, because freshmen can live in here, but like I said, it's first come, first serve, but they gonna go to the upperclassmen first, and what's ever left over to give to the freshmen.
Yeah. So. And then they said, what's the best housing option?
We just said it.
Yeah. Tubman is the best, but if you can't get Tubman, I would say Warren for freshmen.
Warren is not bad. I live in Warren, so Warren is 3 rooms. It's a suite. It's 3 rooms, 2 in each room. So you're living with 6 other girls, and you have 2 showers, but there's 1 shower in the bathroom, which is with the toilet, and then you have a shower, which is like by itself, like it's a door you open and it's a shower. And you have 2 sinks, and it comes with a microwave and a fridge and a freezer. So you do have a little lounge area with the fridge and the freezer and the microwave is. And you do have your own room, but you share with one other roommate, and the whole suite with 6, well, actually, you don't count yourself, with 5 other girls. So it's more so a suite.
Oh, for you, Tubman, yeah, like, it's many different options. Like, me, like, I live in a 4-bedroom suite, so, but in my room, I only have 2 roommates, but usually you have 3 other roommates, and you'll share the bathroom, you'll share the shower. So like one room is just like the toilet, and then the other room is like just the shower, and then you have 2 separate sinks. It's like you and your roommate on your side share that sink, and then your seatmates share that sink. And then there's a suite with the kitchen. Everybody has their own.
The best room. One.
Yeah. But it is expensive. It's more money. Yeah. But everybody has their own room, and then they have a common area, but their bathroom is like the toilet and the shower together. but I think they have two though on each side.
It's two, yes.
Yeah, if you want to like for like, yeah, I'm on my own, like I'm on
party. I'm about to say, if you want more of an apartment type thing.
Yeah, or like, if you want to, like, that's if you want to be on campus. If you want to be off campus, then do the yard. What's the best meal plan, or like, what do you have? What do you choose?
So, I know, well, you can pick any meal plan you have. If you don't have a scholarship, I know for me, because I have a full ride, you get the unlimited on everything, your flex dollars, your meal plan. As far as room and board is concerned, that's all paid for. You don't have to worry about anything. So I know for meal plans, I have the unlimited. I don't know what's the difference between unlimited and the other one. I just know that every time I walk in and swipe it, I'm really worried about it. I don't know, but the flex dollars, I'm telling y'all, I ran out, and it's school year about to be over. I mean, I did it by the time the school year is over, but still, don't spend on flex dollars, because when you really hungry, you won't need them.
For me, I had the 19 meal plan I had, which is like, it's more breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's like every day. So I recommend that, and you get $200 in flex dollars. That's what I got.
They don't tell y'all this, and somebody had to tell me this. So basically, you go to, well, I don't know about the Ville Cab, the calf, because I don't wake up early enough for breakfast, but when we go to Conrad, you swipe, well, it depends on what time you go, but when you go, like, during the day to Conrad, you swipe your meal plan, your meal plan. You can go and eat whatever, but once you leave, you cannot come back. That's a lie. You can come back, and this is what they don't tell y'all, and I'm about to give y'all a tip. You can come back, but tell them you want to use your flex dollars. I was with someone, and she was like, you can use your flex dollars. I said, oh, okay, guess what? So I swiped, because I came back. I had went earlier, and then I came back, and she was like, oh, yeah, you have to leave. I said, oh, I'm using my flex dollars. She's like, oh, it's $9 and some change. She's like, you sure? I said, yes. She swiped it and I went back in.
Well, how much is it to, like, pay? Like, when you flex that, how much do you
come? It was not as $9 and some change to go in there. So, let me tell y'all, don't let that food, well, I don't know, I'll tell next semester, because I don't know if it's going to change. But if it don't change, I'm telling y'all, y'all can go back in a Conrad to get food again, or, like, say if it's Wayne night or something, you went before Wayne night even started, and you wanted to come back, and they say you gotta leave, say you want to use your flex dollars, and you can. So don't let them tell you to leave, because if they say, because they don't tell y'all to use your flex dollars, so use them, but be careful though, because what if you want Grubhub or something, or something from Chick-fil-A, or the Grill? You know, you want to have money for that too, so, but I'm just saying, you can't use your flex in Conrad, they just don't tell you that, but I'm just saying.
So let's just talk about the cost of tuition, or like any scholarships.
As far as tuition, I really don't know, because a lot of people here are either on scholarships or have financial aid.
Or
paying out of pocket with loans. So it's really hard to know like what tuition is, because a lot of people have help. But I know a lot of people say it is expensive, but they have help. As far as like, if you're from Delaware and you're watching this, you can apply for the Inspire Scholarship, and they do help their Delaware residents with that scholarship. So you can apply, I think it's either every semester or every fall semester. I think it's every semester though. You can apply for the Inspire Scholarship, and it pays for half of your tuition.
Yeah, I think it is
every semester. Every semester, it pays for half of your tuition. So if you're from Delaware, I would suggest you get on that. But as far as like outsiders, like from outside of like the state, they do have scholarships that you can apply for. I would say apply for them, and they do help, or get financial aid, but it's just up to you if you have the help and if you have scholarships.
Sally Bay is also like a good private school, but if you want to live in Tubman does not accept no scholarships.
No, nothing. You gotta pay out of pocket. That's why I'm not living.
Get third part by DSU. Pros and cons. So I asked some of my Instagram followers yesterday who go to DSU.
So this is the tea part, because they snap on these.
And they gave us a sperm. Another con. admin and staff works very slow at their own pace. Yes, they do.
That is a fact.
And you better be prepared for them to be playing around. Like, if you got something about financial aid, you have to keep calling them and keep calling them. You need to stay on top of them. Like, oh my, it is so annoying.
They don't even answer emails.
They don't. They be like, oh, leave us an email. Da, da, da. Don't do that. You want to, you can. Maybe you might have luck, honestly, because this one man, I did email him and he did get back to me, but it's a really slight chance that he would have somebody respond to you.
So basically, like, they do suck at communication, but honestly, you have to pull up on these people. If you're trying to get in touch with someone that's part of staff, I suggest y'all call them to a certain extent. Like, if you call them on like a Monday and you keep calling and keep emailing up until like a Wednesday, I would say
pull up.
I suggest y'all pull up on them, because it's like, it's no way you're calling and emailing that much to the point where y'all don't have 2 seconds to pick up the phone.
This is like a con and a pro. It's a small campus. So for it being a con, is that rumors were spread fast. Somebody said rumors spread too fast.
That's very true.
So it's like,
rumors.
Yeah.
They go in and out. Like,
yeah, because
like rumors do go around fast here, but rumors is like, it depends on what it is.
Yeah, it depends on what it is.
Like, because a lot of times you won't know that person is messing with someone unless you talk to someone they know, or yeah, you get into that friend group and it's like, oh.
But it's like, it's a small group, so you know, a lot of people know, like, we mutual people, mutual, they have mutual.
We friends. Hang out where? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a big family living in this one big circle, mm-hmm, and we either talk to that person that you talk to. It's like your friend group, and then another friend group, then another friend group, and then there's like these group of boys over here, and then it's like either one person from that friend group mess with that person, and they're not talking no more than the next person from that friend group, then you mess somebody from that friend group, yeah, and you're like, oh, you used to talk to him? Yeah, I used to talk to him. You're like, oh. Well, when? Oh.
Oh, you did a second?
Well, okay, like, you, at this school, you be finding that out so much stuff, like, and then it'll be like weeks later, like, or when that boy, he'll probably like, he ghosted you like days ago.
Child, and when you talk to somebody, don't ever think they're yours.
Don't. I'm telling you.
When you talk to somebody here on campus,
don't make them your boyfriend.
Don't make them
your boyfriend. They want you.
Don't think that they're yours, because they might go to other people too. Same time, talk to you, Susie, Lori.
I think that's college period. Like, when you get here and you end up talking to someone, just be cautious. Very, very cautious.
And remember what you're here for, okay? Don't let them boys get scared.
Please don't, because no. It's just like, they'll tell you a good story to you.
So, but the pros from it being a small campus is that,
I like the classes.
Yeah, somebody said the class, I don't know where I'm saying, but somebody said like the size of the classrooms, like,
they're not that big.
Yeah, like, they're small. Then they said the campus is a clean environment. The campus is pretty clean. It is very clean.
They make sure, a lot of students here make sure that you clean the campus.
So another pro I would say is they have a lot of organizations. So you have a lot of organizations to choose from to join. And at the beginning of fall semester, you do have org fair. So that's where you can see all the org that you can take part in.
And the orgs here are very, well, the ones that I've been in are very, very, very fun.
Yes, CC. The best, or like,
as far as bonding events, they have the best bonding events, and that's how I met.
They have a lot of events.
Period.
So if you're coming in the fall,
join Companion Champions.
Join Companion Champions.
I promise y'all, I'm not gonna regret joining Companion Champions. It's like, for real, you're gonna come here not knowing people, but as soon as any org in general, like, once you join that org, and you get to bond and meet people, make friends.
I love it. It's a It's like a big, CC is like a big family. Like, I joined CC not knowing nobody. Like, I was shy. I mean, I didn't like first group, but I don't really talk to them again. So I went to the meetings and stuff all by myself. And like, you know, I'm a fine little friend. So I'm like,
just having fun at these events and just like you just be talking to me. And they make sure you talk to people. They make sure you talk because it's like you could be like they'll split you up in groups depending on what the event is. And then like you're not gonna know nobody in your group maybe sometimes. And it's just like you're gonna end up talking to
you
them.
You have to like they don't want no quiet group. Which I do like that because like whether you're shy, it might be like a lot of pressure on you, but I promise you, and you're gonna love it. You're gonna love it. Cause I used to hate it, but I was like, in order for me to meet people, you have to like
step out
and start a conversation because they could be waiting on you to do the same thing.
That's true. That's so true. I always keep thinking about that. I've been thinking about that, like, bro, what if somebody here is shy just like me and they waiting for you to step out?
Yeah.
I really do think about that. That's why I'm like,
that's what my mom told me. Like, I was like, mom, like, I used to go to the phone and stuff, like, I don't really know anybody here. I'd be like, all right, the meeting about to start. I'll talk to you later. The person's telling me, like, somebody could be waiting on you to do the same thing. I took that advice and I started talking when I was going to the events. Like, I would see the mom be like, hey. Then my name, my face, like, oh, hey, Destiny. Once you start going to the events, they try to memorize your name and your face.
Right, and they make sure they don't forget you. Even when there is no CC events or no events of any orgs in general, when you see them, they're going to make sure, like, they speak to you and all that. So it's just like, I suggest as an incoming freshman, you come here and join an organization because, yeah, you might have that little friend group before you get here. But it's good to start like having a family, shall I say, because once you have that, it's like endless friendships after that.
And then you can like network and make many connections from it. So it's good to put yourself out there. So another pro is that I would say this is for any HBCU, but go to HBCU prepares you for the real world.
That's true.
But for DSU, I know we have career fairs, and then they be having internships, and things like say meet day and honors program.
And they have, so it depends on which org you join as well. Cause certain orgs, like I know Mocha, they, which is for like the males, they, cause I just did a live yesterday, which was today, April 21st. April 20th, yesterday, whenever this comes out. So April 20th, I just did a live with the upcoming Mr. and Miss Sophomore.
Shout out to you, Elijah.
But I just did a live with them April 20th, which was yesterday. And he's part of Elijah Brown, which is, who is Mr. Sophomore. He was talking about Mocha, and he was saying how like they teach you which suits to wear, what color suits to wear, how to dress yourself, how to wear a belt, how to do it, how to tie a tie, how to do certain things. It's just like, depending on the orgs you join, and also it depends on who you meet, you really can learn from upperclassmen here. Like,
I really like that. I really like how they teach the differences to wear. I like that.
Oh, the live is on HiveRadio_WDSU. April 20th, look at the live. We talked about freshman advice and their goals and everything for their upcoming real writing, which by the time you see this, they might not be starting their writing, but they start their writing in May. So, yeah.
Do you have anything for that?
I don't know. I guess I would say, like, make sure you network with people here in general, like, as far as staff and stuff, because when you need help, they can help you and they can tell you the tricks of the trade here. Because, like I said, if you don't network and meet people, you're not going to know, like, the tricks of the trade. Because, like, they're going to, like, certain people, like I said, with the meal plan thing, oh, yeah, one swipe, you can't come back. Tricks of the trade, you meet and network people like I did. I met someone and she told me, you can use your flex. I use my flex when I was in. So it's just like, for real, I would say just network a lot, be social. I mean, if you're anti-social, it's okay. Just start breaking out of your shell a little bit.
Yeah, so
That's one thing like DSU is really big on is networking, like put yourself out there. It's very important to network. Like, even if you're shy, you can't
You gotta get out of there.
Yeah, like I'm shy and I'm really trying to get out of here. Like
I was forced.
Yes, we got Miss Juneteenth right here.
The one and only.
I'm
Salaya.
Miss Juneteenth.
But I'm so serious. Like break out of your shell, bro. I was forced, so it's like I'm used to it. Am I still antisocial? Yes, very much so. But like, it depends on what event it is, like, or who I'm around, because I'm still not the first to go up to you and talk to you. I probably have to be around a group of people for me to talk to you. And now that I'm not like home as much anymore, I really stepped out a lot more than I was when I was home. So like college really breaks you out of a shell that you never thought you was gonna come out.
Oh, so you do get iPads.
Oh yes. All the majors except mass communication.
It's included in your tuition.
Yes, I'll get to mass communications because I'm a mass comm major. So all the majors here, you do get an iPad. And it comes with your, and it's part of your tuition. You get an iPad and a little pencil that comes with it in a case. And then in the case is a keyboard that you can use. Now, mass communications majors, we get MacBooks. So you don't get an iPad, you get MacBooks. I don't know why we don't get iPads. I kind of want the iPad, but it's okay. You do get MacBooks. It's in your tuition as well. Only mass comm majors get MacBooks, and every other major gets iPads. Mm.
That's really
good, I think. And you get when you get the iPad, you get an Apple Pencil, and they give you a case. With the case comes a keyboard.
A keyboard, yeah.
Yeah, you guys, if you have any more questions, make sure to leave it in the comment. And I hope y'all took a lot of notes from this video. And if you're going to commit, we'll see you in the fall.
Yeah, we meet people too. We don't bite.
So yeah, thank you for watching my video. Thank you for being a guest. So make sure you guys like, comment, share, and subscribe. And like I said before, if you have any questions, don't be scared. Leave them in the comments. And I answer your questions.
You should have been listening in. Too busy glistening, and why you ain't listen then, listen back then.